Welcome students, in this video we will learn about inheritance and variation topic from class 12th biology. In that the point that is types of crosses we will learn. Okay, and the first cross is that test cross. So what is test cross or why it is used? There are different type of crosses. What is happens in cross? We are doing the hybridization or reproduction. Okay, so which type of cross we are using here? That is test cross is used to find out the true genetic makeup. True genetic makeup means what are the genotypes of that individual we have to identify, and for that we are doing test. Okay, with that true genetic makeup, that is genotype of an individual with the dominant phenotype. Okay, so what we need, that which type of individual is having the dominant phenotype. So what we have to do, that we have to do to cross the individual with a homozygous recessive individual. So this is very important. Homozygous recessive individual means we need that type of genotype which is having dominant characters. Okay, and that dominant characters we need to express in the next generation. So we have to find out that which type of parents are having that type of genotypes, because genotypes are not easy, not able to see by our eyes. So we have to do this type of cross, and the phenotypic characters are showing us that which type of parents is having which type of genotypes, either they are having recessive or dominant. So we have to cross the individual with a homozygous recessive, means we are having one unknown individual, so we have to cross with them by recessive individuals. Okay, recessive genotypes. So then what are the ratios we will get? From that we can easily identify that which type of individual is having the dominant characters. So let's see, we will take one example. For example, we will take the tallness. Okay, tallness is character denoted by capital T. Okay, and dwarfness is denoted by, obviously the contrasting character for capital T is small t. Okay, whenever we are using capital T means dwarfness, so the same character we are using in the lower case for the genetics purpose. Okay, so these are the characters. Now we will take case first, three cases we will take. Okay, so this is the situation first, that we will take one capital individual, means this is the dominant individual. We have to cross them with the recessive individuals, homozygous recessive. So we have to take both are homozygous. So we will cross them with small t, small t. So by using this checker box also, we can easily find out what are the genotypes. Okay, so we will do the checker box for them. So in this checker box also, we can write down one side male gametes, okay, and another side female gametes. So here dominants are there, so we will write down this way, dominant, capital T, capital T, and another side we will write down the recessive character, so small t, and another one gamete is small t. So what we will do, we have to write down the gametes, capital T from here and small t here, again capital T from this and small t here, dominant T here, recessive T here, dominant T here and recessive T here. So what we will get, that all are four are showing the tallness character, means these are heterozygous tall. The parent is homozygous tall, but the genotypes which is present in F1 generation, this is their F1 generation. So all are having tallness. So we will write down them 4:0. So 4:0. Okay, so all are tall. Always we are writing tallness at first and then dwarfness at second, means dominant characters we are writing first and then we are writing the dwarfness. Okay, so all heterozygous tall. Okay, so this is the case first. Now we will take second example. Okay, in this situation we will take the parent means one parent is having heterozygous stall. Okay, so it is having capital T and small t, and it will cross with the homozygous recessive because this is suppose unknown. Okay, this is also unknown. This is also unknown, but for our reference purpose, we are writing them the genotypes. And suppose this is unknown, which is having heterozygous tallness, it will cross with small t, small t. So, which type of gametes we will get? Here we will write down male gametes and here female gametes. Small t. Okay. Here we have to write down the small t and second character small t and small t. Okay. So here we will get capital T and one is recessive. Here both are recessive. Here one is dominant, another one is recessive. And here both are recessive. So we can count that which type of gametes we are getting. Here 1 and 2 both are having one tallness. Okay. And another one is dwarfness. So we can write down here capital T, small t, these are 1 and 2, so these are 2. Okay, and small t, these are also 2. So this is the first ratio, 4 is to 0, and this is second ratio, 2 is to 2. Okay, so this is the second ratio. In this half are having tallness and half are having dwarfness genotypes. Okay. This is 2 is to 2. We can write down 1 is to 1 also. So we can write here also 1 is to 1 also. This is the same meaning that 2 is to 2 is the 1 is to 1 ratio also. Okay. Now we will write down another one. Case third. Okay. Situation third we will write down here. Up to now we have taken one totally homozygous stall. Second case we have taken heterozygous stall. In third case we will see the individual may be having the recessive character. So we will take the recessive. Okay. So third case is small t. This is also unknown. Means we are taking three possibilities and we are crossing them with recessive individual. So here again the recessive individuals. Which type of phenotypes we will get? Again we will do the Punnett square. Male gametes we will write, female gametes we will write. Small t and small t here because this is the unknown parent. Then again we will write down the small t and small t here. In this situation also all are having the dwarfness. Means both side. Both parents are having dwarfness. So, none of the individual is showing the tallness character. So, everyone is having the dwarfness. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, this ratio is 4 is to 0. 0 is to 4, sorry. 0 is to 4. Means, always we are writing the here tallness and second dwarf. Okay. So, dwarf are having 4 characters here, 4 gametes and tallness is having 0. So, 4 is to 0 is the third type ratio. So, these are the phenotypic ratios. In this situation, we can find out that which type of parent is having the dominant character. So, suppose in exams, they have given that one individual is having 4 is to 0 ratio. That, so which type of gametes he is having? So, it is having the capital T because 4 is to 0 is always coming in case of monohybrid dominant case. Okay, monohybrid cross and that is dominant case. 4 is to 0. If they are asking that which type of gametes we are having in which the individual is having heterozygous. Okay, so we heterozygous stall. So which we will get that 2 is to 2 or 1 is to 1. Okay, same thing is that if they are saying that all individuals are showing 0 is to 4 ratio. It means they are having the 0 is to 4 ratio, that is recessiveness. Okay. So this is about the test cross. This test cross is used to find out the unknown genotype we have taken these three unknown genotype, capital T, small t and small t, small t. And every individual was crossed with the recessive one. Okay. So, this is about one type of cross. In next video, we will learn the next cross. Thank you.